Welcome back, everyone. We now go to a developing news story out of our nation's capital as President Trump is taken to Walter Reed Medical Center. You know, late last night, the president announced on Twitter that he and the first lady tested positive for COVID-19. This was just hours after senior aide Hope Hicks tested positive after traveling with the president several times this week.
Joining us now live by phone, U.S. Congressman Louie Gohmert of Tyler.
Yeah, as you might remember, Congressman Gohmert is a COVID survivor himself. Good evening, Congressman.
Good evening, Casey Neal. Great to be with you.
Congressman, this is what everybody wants to know. So pretty much they said he got it from one of his assistants, the COVID-19, going to Minnesota. You basically have the same health care system he has there in D.C., being a U.S. congressman. How long do you think he's going to be down, 10 to 14 days or what?
Well, it's hard to know, but, you know, he's continued to say in his statement as he went to Walter Reed that this was, you know, nothing serious. And I was wondering about that, how in the world he would quarantine at the White House, because there is always something coming up, always somebody that needs to run in and get this or that. So I do think this is a good thing. And so When I quarantined in Tyler and just shut the whole world out, that is a whole lot different than what the president's dealing with. So I think it's a good idea that he goes to Walter Reed. He's taking a cocktail of things, just about everything that I took. Of course, I'd talked to his doctors when I was diagnosed. But he does have a little better care than I do, I can tell you that, Neil. But I think, you know, despite all the sad wishings that some people are laying on him, not wanting him to survive, I had the same thing. But I had a lot of people praying for me in addition to resting and taking, you know, the vitamin C, D, zinc, azithromycin, HCQ, nebulizer. We had people praying, and I got messages from all over the country, and the president's getting them too. He's getting them from all over the place. So many people are wishing him the best, but he's got some people that pray to a God that he and I don't pray to, and apparently that was not as strong as the one we played to.
Well, yeah, it's unfortunate in situations like this. It can bring out the worst in humanity, but also the best. Congressman Gohmert, we've been hearing from White House advisors that President Trump will continue to carry on his presidential duties. Now, just asking, when you were in quarantine and you were battling COVID, was it possible for you to continue doing your job while you were healing?
Yeah, it was to do it online, but I started out taking numerous phone calls, and I realized, look, this is an illness, and it will destroy my throat if I don't respect that. And so I did. I worked online, but I had to quit doing phone calls for a couple of days there. And so he really does. He needs the rest. And my wife thinks maybe it's because I got 7 days of rest. Only had 2 days of symptoms, but I hadn't had that much rest, and who knows when. And so if he's able to rest and just work online and not work his voice too much, then he'll be fine. He's in amazingly good shape.
Congressman, thank you very much for your time.